dentistry. Strong his arm and keen his dentures. He's a pirate now.
Is the dog to Frederick's dentures? Frederick sounds amazing dentures.
2 and 20 now he's rising, and alone he's fit to fly. Which revenge on signalizing bringeth unusual rare high.
Is the dog to Frederick's dentures? Frederick sounds amazing dentures. For aboard the pirate ship, he'll fill the pirate.
For your kindly wishes. Would that I could repay them as they deserve.
What do you mean?
Today I am out of my indentures, and today I leave you forever.
What? But this is quite unaccountable. A keener hand, a scuttling a Cunada, or cutting out a white star, never shipped a hand spike.
Yes, I have done my best for you. And why? It was my duty under my indentures, and I am the slave of duty. As a child, I was regularly apprenticed to your band. It was through an error. No matter, the mistake was ours, not yours, and I was in honor bound by it.
An error? War error!
I mustn't tell you, it would reflect upon my well-loved roof.
Play, dear master, my mind has long been gnawed by the cankering tooth of mystery. Better have it out at once. When Friedrich was a little lad, he proved so brave and daring. His father thought he'd apprentice him to some career seafaring. I was, alas, his nursery mate, and so it fell to my lot to take and bind this promising boy, apprentice to a pilot. A life not bad for a hearty lad, nor surely not a high lot. Though I'm a nurse, you might do worse than make your boy a pilot. I was a stupid nursery maid, a breaker's always scheming, and I did not catch the word aright through being hard of hearing, mistaking my instructions, which within my brain did direct. I took and bound this promising boy, apprentice to a pirate. A sad mistake it was to make, and doom him to a vile lot. I bound him to a pirate view, instead of to a pilot. My master, a nursery maid is not afraid of what you people call work. So I made up my mind to go as a kind of piratical maid of all work. And that is how you find me now, a member of your shy lot. But you wouldn't have bound had he been bound. Apprentice to a pilot. Oh, pardon, Frederick, pardon.
Rise, sweet one, I have long pardoned you.
The two words were so much alike.
They were, they still are, though years have rolled over their heads. But this afternoon, my obligation ceases. Individually, I love you all with affection unspeakable. But collectively, I look upon you with a disgust that amounts to absolute detestation. Oh, pity me, my beloved friends, for such is my sense of duty that once out of my indentures, I shall feel myself bound to devote myself heart and soul to your extermination.
Poor lad! Poor lad!
Well, Frederick, if you conscientiously feel it is your duty to destroy us, we cannot blame you for acting on that conviction. Always act in accordance with the dictates of your conscience, my boy, and chance the consequences.
And besides, we can offer you a little temptation to remain with us. We don't seem to make piracy pay.
I'm sure I don't know why, but we don't.
Well, alas, I know why. But I mustn't tell you. It wouldn't be right.
Why not, my boy? It's only 11:30, and you're one of us until the clock strikes 12.
Get out! All right.
Well, then.
And until then, you are bound to protect our interests.
Yeah. Okay. It is my duty as a pirate to tell you that you are too tender-hearted. For instance, you make a point of never attacking a weaker party than yourselves. And when you attack a stronger party, you invariably get thrashed.
There is some truth in that.
Then again, you make a point of never attacking an orphan.
But of course, we are orphans ourselves. And know what it is.
Yes, but it has got about, and what is the consequence? Everyone we capture says he's an orphan! The last three ships we took claimed to be manned entirely by orphans! So we had to let them go. One would think that Great Britain's mercantile navy was recruited solely from her orphan asylums. Which we know is not the case.
But hang it all, you can have us absolutely merciless.
Yeah. There's my difficulty. Until 12 o'clock, I would. After 12, I would. Was ever a man placed in so delicate a situation?
And Ruth, your own Ruth, whom you love so well, and who has won her middle-aged way into your boyish heart. What is to become of her?
He will take you with him.
Well, Ruth, I feel some little difficulty about you. It is true that I admire you very much, but I have been constantly at sea since I was 8 years old, and yours is the only woman's face I have seen during that time. I think it is a sweet face.
It is! Oh, it is!
Well, I say I think it is. That is my impression. But as I have never had an opportunity of comparing you with other women, it is just possible I may be mistaken.
True.
What a terrible thing it would be if I were to marry this innocent person and then to find out that she is on the whole plain.
Oh, Ruth is very, very well, very well. Indeed.
Yes, there are the remains of a fine woman about Ruth.
Do you really think so?
I do.
Well, then I will not be so selfish as to take her from you. In justice to her and in consideration for you, I will leave her behind.
No! Frederick, this must not be. We are rough men, in a rough life, but we are not so utterly heartless as to deprive thee of thy love. I think I am right in saying that there is not one here who would rob thee of this inestimable treasure for all the world holds dear.
Not one!
No, I thought there wasn't. Keep thy love, Frederick, keep thy love.
You're very good, I'm sure.
Well, it's the top of the tide and we must be off. Farewell, Frederick. When your process of extermination begins, let our deaths be as swift and painless as you can conveniently make them.
I will. By the love I have for you, I swear it. Would that you could render this extermination unnecessary by accompanying me back to civilization.
No, Frederick, it cannot be. I don't think much of our profession, but contrasted with respectability, it is comparatively honest. No, Frederick, I shall live and die a pirate king!
Thank you.
sanctimonious part of the pirate head and a pirate heart. Away to the cheating world go, where pirates are not held to do, but I'll be true to the song I sing and live and die upon.
Reserve. Compared with other women, how are you?
I will answer you truthfully, Master. I have a slight cold, but otherwise I am quite well.
I am sorry for your cold, but I was referring rather to your personal appearance. Compared with other women, are you beautiful?
I have been told so, dear Master.
Ah, but lately?
No. Years and years ago.
What do you think of yourself?
It is a delicate question to answer, but I think I am a fine woman.
That is your candid opinion?
Yes, I would be deceiving you if I told you otherwise.
Oh, thank you, Ruth. I believe you, for I am sure you will not practice on my inexperience. I wish to do the right thing. And if, I say if, you really are a fine woman, your age shall be no obstacle to our union. Hark! Surely I hear voices. Who dares to approach our orbit's inaccessible lair? Can it be Custom House? No, it does not sound like Custom House.
Confusion! It is the voices of young girls. If he shall see them, I am lost.
By all that's marvelous! Bevy of beautiful maidens!
I am lost! Lost! Lost!
Oh, how lovely! How surpassingly lovely is the plainest of them! What grace! What delicacy! What refinement! And Ruth! Ruth told me she was beautiful! done so. Your face is lined, your hair is grey.
Glad you finally got so.
Faithless woman, to deceive me, I who trust and saw.
Master, master, do not leave me, hear me ere you go.
Faithless woman,
master, master,
faithless woman,
master, master, do not leave me, do not leave me, hear me ere.
Oh. What a picturesque spot. I wonder where we are.
And I wonder where Papa is. We left him ever so far behind.
Oh, he'll be here presently. Remember, dear Papa is not as young as we are. And we came over a rather difficult country.
Yes, but how thoroughly delightful it is to be so entirely alone.
Why, in all probability, we are the first human beings to ever set foot on this enchanting spot.
Except the mermaids! It's the very place for mermaids!
Who are only human beings down to the waist.
And who can't be said to set foot strictly anywhere. Tails they may, but feet they cannot.
But what shall we do until Papa and the servants arrive with the luncheon?
Well, we are quite alone. Suppose we take off our shoes and stockings and paddle.
Stop, ladies, pray. I had intended not to intrude myself upon your notice in this effective but alarming costume. But under these peculiar circumstances, it is my bounden duty to inform you that your proceedings will not be unwitnessed.
But who are you, Sir Speaker?
I am a pirate.
A pirate?
Ladies, do not shun me. This evening I renounce my vile profession. And to that end, O pure and peerless maidens, O blushing buds of ever-blooming beauty, I sore at heart, implore your kind assistance.
How pitiful his tale, how rare his beauty,
how pitiful.
I love you.
but one.
No, no.
How beautifully blue the sky, the clouds are rising very
must not lose our senses. Men who stick out no offences will anon be here. Piracy, the dreadful trade is. Pray you get you hence, young ladies, while the coast is clear.
No, we must not lose our senses. If we stick at no offences, we should not be here. Piracy, the dreadful trade is. Nice companions for young ladies. Let us hear.
Such affairs as sorties and surprises I'm more wary at. and when. I know precisely what is meant by commissarial. When I have heard that progress has been made in modern gunnery, when I know more of tactics than a novice in a nunnery. In short, when I'm a smattering of elemental strategy.
Strategy,
Catapult.
No, I'll start to catch some
Professor!
Brilliant!
You say a better major general has never strategy.
You say a better major general has never strategy. You say a better major general has never strategy. You say a better major general has never strategy.
For my military knowledge, though I'm funky and adventuring, has only been brought up to the beginning of the century. But still in matters vegetable, animal, and mineral, I am the very model of a modern major general.
But still in matters vegetable, animal, and mineral, he is the very model of a modern major general.
I shall explain in two words. We propose to marry your daughters.
But you mustn't do that.
May I ask? This is a picturesque uniform, but I'm not familiar with it. What are you?
We are all single gentlemen.
Oh, yes, I gathered that. Anything else?
No, nothing else.
Do not believe him, Papa. They are pirates, the famous Pirates of Penzance.
The Pirates of Penzance? I have often heard of them.
All except for this gentleman, who was a pirate once, but who is out of his indentures today and means to lead a blameless life evermore.
Happy birthday, Frederick.
But wait a bit. I object to pirates as sons-in-law.
We object to Major Generals as fathers. But we waive that point. We do not press it. We look over.
An idea. And do you mean to say that you would deliberately rob me of these, the sole remaining props of my old age, and leave me to go through the remainder of my life unfriended, unprotected, and alone?
Well, yes, that's the idea.
Tell me, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan?
Oh, dash it all!
Here we are again.
I ask you, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan?
Orphan?
Yes, orphan. Have you ever known what it is to be one?
I say, orphan.
Orphan, orphan, orphan!
I don't think we quite understand one another. I ask you, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan?
And you say orphan. As I understand you, you are merely repeating the word orphan to show that you understand me.
I didn't repeat the word orphan.
Pardon me, you did indeed.
I only repeated it once.
True, but you repeated
yes,
it.
Yes, but not orphan.
Stop! I think I see where we are getting confused. When you say orphan,
did you mean orphan?
A person who has lost his parents,
or orphan frequently?
I beg pardon, I see what you mean. Frequently.
You said orphan frequently.
No, only once.
Exactly, you said orphan frequently only once.
Poor fellow.
Take at your feet they kneel. Your heart you cannot steal against the sad, sad tale of the lonely
Oh, Master, hear one word
did deceive me.
Away, you did deceive him.
Oh, do not leave me.
Oh, do not leave her.
Away, you grieve me.
Away, you grieve him.
I wish you'd leave me.
Never was such opportunity to get married with impunity. Give up the felicity of a parfait domesticity. Now a doctor of divinity is located in this vicinity.
Lives of a magnanimity, this place to lay sanctity. Never was such opportunity to get married with impunity. Give up the felicity of a bounded domesticity.
Give up the felicity, of a bounded domesticity. Give up the felicity, of a bounded domesticity. Give up the felicity, of a bounded domesticity.
I will try, dear Mabel, but why does he sit here night after night in this draughty old ruin?
Why do I sit here? To escape from the pirate's clutches. I described myself as an orphan, and heaven help me, I am no orphan. I come here to humble myself before the tombs of my ancestors and to implore their pardon for having brought dishonor on the family escutcheon.
But you forget, sir, you only bought the property a year ago. The stucco on the baronial castle is scarcely dry.
Frederick, in this chapel are ancestors. You cannot deny that. With the estate, I bought the chapel and its contents. Now, I don't know whose ancestors they were, but I know whose ancestors they are, and I shudder to think that their descendants by purchase, if I may so describe myself, should have brought disgrace on what I have no doubt was an unstained escutcheon.
Be comforted. Had you not acted as you did, these reckless men would assuredly have called in the nearest clergyman and have married your large family on the spot.
I thank you for your profit, Solace, but it is unavailing. I assure you, Frederick, that such is the anguish and remorse I feel at the abominable falsehood by which I escaped these easily deluded pirates, that I would go to the simple-minded chief this very night and confess all. Did I not fear that the consequences would be most disastrous to myself? At what time does your expedition march against these scoundrels?
At 11. And before midnight, I wish to have atoned for the involuntary association with the pestilent scourges by sweeping them from the face of the earth. And then, dear Mabel, you will be mine.
Are your devoted followers at hand?
They are. They only await my orders.
Then, Frederick, let your escort, lion-hearted, be summoned to receive a general's blessing. Ere they depart upon their dread adventure.
Dear sir, they come.
Oh, come here. Oh, lovely. Well,
and we find the wisest thing,
ta-ra-ta-ra, ta-ra-ta-ra,
is to slap our chests and sing,
ta-ra-ta-ra.
Go and threat it with the mutes,
ta-ra-ta-ra, ta-ra-ta-ra,
and your heart is in your butes,
ta-ra-ta-ra.
There's nothing brings us round like the trumpet's martial sound, like the trumpet's martial sound,
ta-ra-ta-ra, ta-ra-ta-ra.
The song.
intentions are a bit. Yes, it's very evident. These intentions are a bit evident. Yes, we're meant evident. Ah, yes, well meant. When the phone gets sent, ta-ra-ta-ra-ta-ra-ta-ra.
I shouldn't be surprised if it were owing to the agency of an ill-natured fairy. You
are the victim of this clumsy arrangement, having been born in leap year on the 29th of February. And so, through a simple arithmetical process, you'll easily discover that although you live 21 years, yet if we go by birthdays, you're only 5 and a little bit over. Dear me, let's see. Yes, yes, with yours my figures do agree. How quaint the ways of paradox. Common sense she gaily mocks. Though counting in the usual way is 21 I've been alive, yet reckoning by my natal day, yet reckoning by my natal day, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 I am a little by a 5. A paradox, a paradox, a paradox, is paradox.
To look at me.
You're glad now, I'll be bound, that you spared us.
Yes, yes.
You would have never forgiven yourself when you discovered you had killed 2 of your comrades.
My comrades?
I'm afraid you don't appreciate the delicacy of your position. You apprenticed to us.
Until I reached my 21st year.
No, until you reached your 21st birthday. And going by birthdays, you are as yet only 5 1/4.
You don't mean to say you are going to hold me to that?
No, we merely remind you of the fact and leave the rest to your sense of duty.
Your sense of duty.
Oh, don't put it on that footing. As I was merciful to you just now, be merciful to me. I implore you not to insist on the letter of your bond, just as the cup of happiness is at my lips.
We insist on nothing. We content ourselves by pointing out to you your duty.
Your duty? Well, you have appealed to my sense of duty, and my duty is only too clear. I abhor your infamous calling. I shudder at the thought that I have ever been mixed up with it. But duty is before all. At any price, I will do my duty.
Bravely spoken. Come, you are one of us once more.
Lead on, I follow. Oh, horror!
What is the matter?
What did I tell you? No, no, I cannot do it. And yet, as one of your band...
Speak out! I charge you by that sense of conscientiousness to which we have never yet appealed in vain.
General Stanley, the father of my Mabel.
Yes, yes.
He escaped from you on the plea that he was an orphan.
He did.
It breaks my heart to betray the honored father of the girl I adore. But as your apprentice, I have no alternative. General Stanley is no...
Yes?
General Stanley is no orphan!
What?
Well, more than that, he never was one!
Am I to understand that? To save his contemptible life, he dared to practice on our credulous simplicity. Our revenge shall be swift and terrible. We will go and collect our band and attack Tremorin Castle this very night.
But stay!
Not a word. He is doomed.
Away, away, my heart's on fire. I burn this beast, he says, shall truly be. This very night, my vengeance dire shall rot itself in God. Away, away.
Away, away, yet I expire. I find my duty hard to do today. My heart is filled with anguish dire. It strikes me to the core. Away, away.
Also bound the drift is the night. Vengeance how the pirate so decides. Our nature's dead, he's fallen with his lies. And in return, tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, yes, tonight the traitor dies. Yes, yes, tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, or early tomorrow.
His girls likewise.
They will render in sorrow.
The ones are smart.
know that
two of you shall have each. Tonight he dies as early tomorrow. His girls likewise they will mount him in sorrow. The one so smart in the natures they cherish, and all who got two of you shall perish. Away, away, away,
away.
In 1940, I of age shall be. I'll then return and claim you, I declare it.
It seems so long.
Swear that till then you will be true to me.
Yes, I'll be strong. By all the Stanleys dead and gone, I swear it.
Oh, here is love, and here is truth, and here is food for joy. Us, that she will be faithful to the soon.
Till we are wedded, even after.
Oh, here is love, and here is truth.
Oh, here's love, and here's truth.
She will be faithful to her soon.
Till
we are wedded, even after. And even after,
just even after.
Oh, here is love, and here is truth, and here is hope for joy as ever. She will be faithful to his suit, till we are wed, and even after.
He will be faithful to his suit,
till we are wed, and even
after.
Oh, here is love, and here is truth,
oh, here is love,
understand it at all.
Still, as he's actuated by a sense of duty.
That makes a difference, of course. At the same time, we repeat, we cannot understand it at all.
No matter. Our course is clear. We must do our best to capture these pirates! Alone?
By our fellow erring creatures and deprived of that liberty which is so dear to us all. But we should have thought of that before we joined the force.
We should.
It is too late now.
It is.
When a
fell, it's not engaging his employment.
His employment.
For maturing his helonious little plans.
Little plans.
His capacity for innocent enjoyment.
Set enjoyment.
Is just as great as any honest man's.
Honest man's.
Our feelings we with difficulty smother.
Difficulty smother.
When constabulary duties to be done.
To be done.
I'll take one consideration with another.
With another.
Listen's lot is not an happy one.
Whoa. Is not an happy one. Happy one.
When the enterprising burglar's not a burgling.
Not a burgling.
When the cutthroat isn't occupied in crime.
Hide in crime.
He loves to hear the little brook a-gurgling.
Brook a-gurgling.
And listen to the merry village chime.
Village chime.
When the costa's finished jumping on his mother.
On his mother.
He loves to lie a-basking in the sun.
In the sun.
I'll take one consideration with another.
With another.
A leaseman's lot is not an happy one.
Oh, when constabulary duties to be done, to be done. A policeman's lot is not an happy one, happy one.
We feel no sound at all.
hush, not a word. I see a light inside. The Major General comes, so quickly hide.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes. Tormented with the anguished dread of falsehood unatoned, I lay upon my sleepless bed and tossed and turned and groaned. The man who fights his conscience ache no peace at all enjoys. And as I lay in bed awake, I thought I heard a noise.
He thought he heard a noise.
Ha ha!
No, all is still in dale on hill. My mind is set at ease. So still the scene, it must have been the sighing of the softly to the river comes alive. prayer and resolution manly, for death prepare on happy General Stanley.
Is he to die, and shriven and unyield?
Oh, Stanley!
Aye!
You've contrived, but your proud triumph will not be long-lived.
Don't say you're orphans, for we know that
on your allegiance we've a stronger claim. We charge you here. We charge you. In the Queen Victoria's name,
you do.
We do. We charge you.
Who happily resides in the immediate vicinity.
has only been Madame from the beginning of the century, but still getting off my daughters, 8, 9, or 10 in all. I've shown myself the model of a modern major general.
But still getting off his daughters, 8, 9, or 10 in all, he's shown himself the model.